We live in the 21st century, but for a moment, I would like to take your memories back to 19th century and would like to introduce you to a person whose name is on your lips and whose image is embedded in your books and dress. Do you know who it is? Yes, it is none other than the patron of our school, Vincent Pallotti. Vincent Pallotti was an extraordinary man who was a light in the Rome of his time. In fact, he is known as the Apostle of Rome. And today, we live at a time when people seek for a personal experience of God and search for true people of God who can inspire and enlighten us. Dear friends, in St. Vincent Pallotti, we have a priest and saint who is possessed by God and who loves to share this possession with our students. So we are here to present before you few glimpses from the life of St. Vincent Pallotti. Parents come to school seeking admission for Vincent.
Good morning, Father.
Good morning.
Father, we have come here seeking for an admission for our child in your school.
Okay. Please be seated. But tell me, who are you both?
I am Peter Paul Pallotti and this is my wife Maria Di Rossi. This is Vincent, our third child. Father, we would like our child be taught in our Christian school, giving him the values of Jesus Christ.
That's very good, Peter Pallotti. Vincent, do you go to church?
Yes, Father. I go to church every day with my papa and I pray to Mama Mary daily.
And how do you pray, Vincent?
I kneel before the statue of Mama Mary and pray to her. Oh, my beloved mother, make me a good boy.
Oh, Vincent, you are so wonderful. Dear parents, we are so happy to have your child in our school. He will surely bring glory to our institution. Vincent, come with me. I will show you our school.
Vincent, how do you like your new school?
Mom, our school is very good. We have a church in the school campus and I love to go to the church and pray to Saint Joseph and Mama Mary. Our principal father is very good and loves us so much. He told me he wants to speak with you.
Yes, tomorrow I will come with you to school.
I love you, Mom. You are so good.
Good morning, Father.
Good morning.
Father, I am so happy to meet you. Tell me, how is my son Vincent?
Madam Maria, your Vincent is a gem. He is a little saint, but he is little weak in studies. I suggest you to make a novena to the Holy Spirit.
Well, suggestion. Today itself, we will go to the Holy Spirit Church and begin the novena.
Pallotti devoutly made novena to the Holy Spirit and he improved in his academics.
Mom, our annual exam results have come and I passed in all subjects with 5 stars. I came first in my class, Mom.
It's God's work. Son, let's pray and celebrate.
After completion of his studies, Vincent Pallotti became a priest and was appointed as the parish priest of the Church of the Holy Spirit. Rome of 1848. There is uncertainty and calamity all over Europe. The very foundation of Europe is rocked by political upheavals. In Italy and Rome, there is total confusion. The very foundation of Christianity and Papal State is at stake. Garibaldi, a terrorist leader, declared, "I will put an end to Christian religion." Rebellious militants surrounded Papal Palace. Not a single priest was allowed to meet the Pope. Everything is controlled at the point of gun. A middle-aged priest, dressed in cassock, walks through the gates of Papal Palace fearlessly to see Pope.
"Hey, stop! Stop there!"
Palotti moves fearlessly.
"What happened? Did I miss the target?
Tell us, who are you?"
"Don't worry, my friend. I am Palotti, Vincent Palotti. We have studied in school together. I too am a soldier now, but I am the soldier of Jesus Christ, against whom you are fighting. Remember, friends, human hands cannot pierce God's almighty hands."
"Hey you, what are you doing here? Don't wait here. The church is closed."
"I am sorry, Father. I just want to do my confession."
"I said church is closed. I cannot open it for public now."
"What is your problem, my lady?"
"I really want to pray for my daughter."
"I am Father Vincent Palotti, the new rector of church. Now you can do happily your confessions."
"Thank you, Father."
"Please open the church for her now. Now the church will be always open. I will be here to meet people and to hear their confessions."
Founding of the Union of the Catholic Apostolate.
"I got an inspiration."
"What inspiration?"
"The law of Christ urges me to make every Catholic a good Catholic, to make every good Catholic an apostle."
"How shall we do that?"
"For that, we need to make a union, the Union of Catholic Apostolate."
"What will be the motto of this union?"
"To proclaim the gospel of Jesus Christ to the world, to promote missionary activities, and to lead all people to unity in Christ."
St. Vincent Palotti aspired to bring about a church which is renewed by the power of apostolic love, and therefore became a sign of unity, hope, and salvation for the people of the world.